Docker init is a new CLI command introduced in Docker Desktop 4.18. Let's see it in action. It's basically a way to help you to Dockerize an application even faster. So we'll test this with a Go application. To start a new Go module, we can do go mod init and any name you want, for example, test. Then we can install some dependencies, for example, go get-u github .com/gingonic, which is a web framework for Go, gin. We install these dependencies. Then we create a file, touch main.go. You can see this file here. Now, let's create a very simple web server. Simple web server with the help of GitHub Copilot. Package main. Let's install some dependencies that we will not use. Probably this one, yes. Function main and something super simple. Hello world and on port 8080. Done. Now let's run this application without Docker. To do this, we can do go run and the name of the file main.go. Okay, we have this allow access. And then we can go on port 8080. And we have hello world. Perfect. This is without Docker. Now, let's try to Dockerize this application. So usually we create some files, a Docker ignore, a Docker file, a Docker compose. With Docker init, we can just type Docker init. And here we have a prompt of commands. This probably will look different in the future, but we are still in beta. So Go detected as suitable for a Go server application. What version of Go 1.20? It's okay. The relative directory here, because I run the command here. The port has been automatically detected. Very nice feature. Mom, can you see below my face? We have now three files. The Docker ignore file, the Docker file to build the image, and a simple Docker compose with one single server. So what we can do now is that we can modify this, and now we can type Docker compose app. Nice. Let's check again on the same port, localhost 8080, and we have hello Docker init. So basically, this command allowed us to create a Docker file, Docker compose file, and Docker ignore super fast.